Tomorrow marks 150 years since Alice in Wonderland was published. In it, the Mad Hatter declares, "You'd have to be half mad to dream me up," which got us wondering, who did dream it up? Anthony Mason goes through the looking glass.
And curiosity often leads to trouble.
Almost from the moment 7-year-old Alice first tumbled down a rabbit hole, her adventures in Wonderland became a classic.
It's never been out of print.
It's never been out of print.
Curator Carolyn Vega of New York's J.P. Morgan Museum says it all began on a boat ride on the River Thames outside Oxford, England in 1862, when a professor told young Alice Little and her two sisters a wild story.
Once the boat ride was over, at the end of the day, she asked for a written copy of the story.
Author Lewis Carroll spent more than 2 years handwriting and illustrating what he first called Alice's Adventures Underground.
So this is the original manuscript.
This is the copy he presented to Alice?
Yes, it's absolutely unique.
Lewis Carroll was the pen name for Oxford mathematician Charles Dodgson.
He's in an elusive figure. He's like a blob of mercury. You put your thumb on him and it just scatters.
Robert Douglas Fairhurst is author of The Story of Alice, Lewis Carroll, and the Secret History of Wonderland.
Why can't we find him?
Partly because he was so intensely private. There's one of his letters in which he says that his main aim is to remain personally unknown to the world.
But he wanted Alice to be known, and he was a shrewd marketer.
He rewrites it for young children. He puts the pictures on biscuit tins. You know, it's like modern franchising.
And when the technology arrived, Alice became a movie star.
This is the first film adaptation?
Originally, it was about 12 minutes long. At the time, in 1903, this made it the longest film yet produced in Britain.
Lewis Carroll's story gave us the Mad Hatter, the White Rabbit, and the Cheshire Cat. But most of all, says Robert Douglas Fairhurst, it's Alice who still attracts us.
She's anything we want her to be. So although Carroll would write a story that sent her through a mirror, in some way she's become a mirror. And what happens is that she reflects ourselves.
150 years later, Alice hasn't aged a day. Anthony Mason, CBS News, New York.